feature in the first two nights.
B2 of 3.
The Clint Bowyer team has struggled just a little bit here in Wheatland, Missouri.
Series, Caden Cornell, 17 years old. Matt Furman also down low, the 51 car. The Furman Builders Rocket, so those cars will go to the back. So we did get a lap in. EPJ, how about that team? Two wins, according to last Friday night at 141 in Wisconsin. Ronnie Stuckey, they've really gelled and doing a great job, Bob.
Ronnie Stuckey, Earl Pearson Jr., two wins to their credit, as you mentioned, this year, second in points. Definitely really, you know, hitting their stride as we approach the summer months. Here's exactly what happened on the racetrack, and you can see Furman went around, and then, you know, the melee ensued right behind him here. But Earl Pearson Jr., the interesting part about him is you see Cornell go to the rear of the field here. He'll be in the joint to try to make it.
But he's never won the Show Me 100, either West Plains or here at Lucas Oil Speedway. How about Shannon Babb, of course, in the early days of this track? He really was fast. Don O'Neill, the 2014 champion. And right now we got Cole Wells slowing and going to the pit area. But 14 to go in this race, and only the top two go. And right now, O'Neill. Some asphalt, but good to see him here tonight. And but right now, He's in trouble here in this first of two B mains. We've got six down, nine to go. Pearson, your leader, back second. So Pearson gets in, Bob. That would mean right now that would leave us with Richards, O'Neill, and Lanigan not yet in to the Show Me 100 here tonight. There's Don O'Neill, the 2014 champion for Clint Bowyer.
And Don O'Neill had a great run in the Diamond Nationals last year. Josh Richards won that event. O'Neill was on the podium. And honestly, this team thought they were going to come in here and do really well. They just have not hit the setup so far this weekend. That ride also out of the Clint Bowyer Racing Stables for Don O'Neill, the real deal. His son Hudson having a much better weekend, but Tony Jackson Jr. in that 56 having a push off the racetrack.
Well, Hudson O'Neill's going to start fourth in the Show Me 100. He's running. Bruce, wait, just gets better. If that's possible. I mean, probably of all that I've been in the sport about 40 years, Bob, and I don't recall a driver at that age, even Bobby Pierce, Tyler Reddick, people like that. This Hudson O'Neill is something else.
He is indeed, and we will watch him tonight in the Show Me 100. Jimmy Mars there, three times a winner of the Lucas Oil Late Model Dirt Series. Slipped back a little bit, Bab able to capitalize on that last restart and grab that final transfer spot. But now those two will start side by side once again here as we inch closer to halfway through B main number two.
Well, we learned after last night, Jimmy Mars and Scott Bloomquist, of course, they have a past history of a few things. They will not be sending Christmas cards to each other this year.
But or any year.
Yeah, or any year.
For a while.
For a while. Well, Pearson looks good now. You notice another thing on Earl's car. He's changed the paint scheme.
I like it.
Yeah.
I like it. A little red and black scheme here after being blue and black to begin the season as we did down at Gold Dial Speedway.